Masculine vibrations are released within the minds of those fortunate students who use the liquids, and they plant the seeds of understanding creation. No suggestion is required for the vibrations to attune the mind, for they are literally baptized with the knowledge. The application of mental gender through the practice of meditation using these sacred publications of creation constitutes one of the earliest forms of religious worship, a form that scattered itself throughout history and extends itself into our modern times. The spirit of your ancestors resides within the sacred soma. It carries the knowledge of creation and awaits to enter you. These vessels of sacred religious worship will open your consciousness to mysteries you will never understand until you allow them to abide within your spirit, mind, and body. Many books, many of them quite good, have been written on the subject of mental gender. The main facts stated in these various books are correct, although the several writers have attempted to explain the phenomenon by various pet theories of their own. By using the theory of mental gender, the student will be able to bring order to the chaos of conflicting theory and teachings and readily make oneself a master of the subject, if so inclined. The consideration of the teachings of Sunam may clear away many perplexing difficulties, a key that will unlock many doors. It is not necessary to go into detail regarding all of the many features of psychic phenomena and mental science. This material can be easily obtained by the student. With the aid of the Sunam teachings, one may go through any library anew. This is not a new philosophy, but rather the outlines of a great world teaching which will make clear the teachings of others, serving as a great reconciler of differing theories and opposing doctrines. 17. Meditation. Where your attention is where you are. Sunam. This great Sunam axiom embodies the idea that all things are subject to the principles of Sunam, including your attention and your spirit. Balance, bringing yourself to the point of equilibrium through balance between mind, body, and spirit produces the complete person. By neutralizing the swing of the pendulum, concentration is focused towards the center, between the opposing points of extremes. The mind surrenders through meditation, rhythmically dancing into the music of pure, alert, clear, total, and disturbed, and open consciousness in the presence of Sunam, and the body is brought to sensitivity through dynamic, rhythmic dance, physical, exhaustive exercise. This ideal meditation is the grand master key to reconciliation and the powers of spiritual psychokinesis. With the reconciliation of the two extremes neutralized and brought into balance, the disciple allows for a smooth, continuous evolution. When the disciple develops the powers of spiritual psychokinesis, he or she becomes a master of the universes. Truly, it is magical. 18. Sunam Axioms. The possession of knowledge, unless accompanied by an expression of action, is like the hoarding of precious metals, a vain and foolish thing. Knowledge, like wealth, is intended for use. The law of use is universal, and those who violate it suffer by reason of their conflict with natural forces. Sunam. The Sunam teachings are not intended to be merely stored away and secreted. If you don't use it, you'll lose it. Beware of mental miserliness and express into action that which you have learned. Study the axioms, but practice and teach them also. Given below are some of the more important Sunam axioms with a few comments added to each. Make these your own and practice and use them, for they are not really yours until you have used and taught them. Experience is the best teacher. Sunam. The systematic law of learning must be applied to all principles in order for one to have real knowledge rather than just belief. This learning requires you to first question the principle. Secondly, you must take activity in the principle and experience the action or the cause and effect of the principle. Thirdly, you move to a knowledge about, rather than a belief in the principle, for the principle and its workings become yours through experience. To change your mood or mental state, change your vibration. Sunam. You may change your mental vibrations by an effort of will, by deliberately fixing the attention upon a more desirable state. will directs the attention and attention changes your vibration. Cultivate the art of attention by means of the will, through meditation, and you have solved the secret of the mastery of moods and mental states. Strengthen and enlarge the will by accumulating kinetic energy from the field of that quote all action and manifested creation. Convert the kinetic energy into potential energy and store it in the will through meditation. Summum. By accumulating kinetic energy and altering it to potential energy, for use by the will, your will may be strengthened and enlarged. Energize the attention with potential energy from the will, then immerse the attention and the will within summum. While immersed in summum, your will and attention are energized with the very essences of creation. During this immersion, kinetic energy from the field of all action and manifested creation is altered into potential energy for storage in your will. To alter an undesirable rate of mental vibration, put into operation the principle of opposition and concentrate upon the opposite point of that which you desire to suppress. Dissolve the undesirable by withdrawing your attention from it. Summum. This is one of the most important of the summum formulas. It is based on true scientific principles. The mental state and its opposite are merely the two contrasting points on the same scale. By mental immersion, the vibration can be altered. This principle is known to modern psychologists who apply it to the breaking up of undesirable habits by instructing their students to concentrate upon the opposing quality. If you are possessed of fear, do not waste time trying to kill it. Instead, cultivate the quality of courage and the fear will disappear. Some writers have expressed this idea most forcibly by using the illustration of the dark room. You do not clear out darkness. Just open the curtains, let in the light, and the darkness disappears. To dissolve a negative quality, concentrate the attention on the positive point of that same quality. The vibrations will gradually change from negative to positive, until finally you become fixed on the positive point. The reverse is also true, as many have found to their sorrow, when they allowed themselves to vibrate too constantly on the negative point. By changing your vibration, you may master your moods, change your mental states, remake your disposition, and build up character. Much of the mental mastery of the advanced masters is due to this application of immersion, which is one of the more important aspects of mental psychokinesis. Remember the summum axiom, which says mind, as well as metal and elements, may be altered psychokinetically, from state to state, degree to degree, proportion to proportion, condition to condition, point to point, vibration to vibration. Psychokinesis is mental mastery. The mastery of immersion is the mastery of the fundamental principle of psychokinesis or mental alteration. For, unless one acquires the art of altering their own vibration, they will be unable to affect their environment. An understanding of this principle will empower one to change their own vibration as well as that of others, if you will but devote the time, care, study, and meditative techniques necessary to master the art. The principle is true, but the results obtained depend upon the persistent patience and practice of the student. Rhythm may be neutralized by an application of the art of immersion. Summum. As explained in a previous chapter, summum holds that the principle of rhythm manifests on the mental levels as well as the physical. Further, the bewildering succession of moods, feelings, emotions, and other mental states are due to the backward and forward swing of the mental pendulum that carries you from one extreme of feeling to another. Summum also teaches that the law of neutralization enables one, to a great extent, to overcome the operation of rhythm. There are both higher and lower levels of consciousness. By rising mentally to the higher level, the master causes the swing of the mental pendulum to manifest on the lower level, and by dwelling on the higher level, escapes the consciousness of the swing backward. This is effected by immersing in the higher self, and thus raising the mental vibrations of the ego above those of the ordinary levels of consciousness. It is similar to the process of rising above a force and allowing it to pass beneath you. The advanced students immerse themselves at the positive point of their being, the point of spirit, rather than the point of personality. By refusing to participate in the operation of rhythm, they raise themselves above its level of function. Standing firm in their statement of being, they allow the pendulum to swing back upon the lower levels without changing their fixed position of immersion. This is accomplished by all individuals who have attained any degree of self-mastery, whether they understand the law or not. Such persons simply refuse to allow themselves to be swung back by the pendulum of mood and emotion, and by steadfastly affirming the superiority of spirit, they remain fixed on the positive point. The masters, of course, attain a far greater degree of proficiency, because they understand the law which they are overcoming through the use of a higher law. By use of their will, they attain a degree of poise and mental steadfastness almost impossible to believe by those who allow themselves to be swung backward and forward by the mental pendulum of moods and feelings. Remember always, however, that you do not really destroy the principle of rhythm, for that is indestructible. You simply overcome one law by counterbalancing it with another, thus maintaining an equilibrium. The laws of balance and counterbalance are in operation on the mental as well as on the physical levels. An understanding of these laws seemingly enables one to overthrow laws, while in fact they are merely exerting a counterbalance. Nothing escapes the principle of cause and effect, destiny, but there are many levels of the law, and one may use laws of the higher to overcome the laws of the lower. Summum. An understanding of the practice of immersion allows you to rise to a higher level of cause and effect and thus counterbalance the laws of the lower levels. By rising above the level of ordinary causes you become, to a degree, a cause instead of an effect. Able to master your own moods and feelings and to neutralize rhythm, you are able to escape a great part of the operation of cause and effect on the ordinary level. The masses are carried along, obedient to their environment. The wills and desires of others overpower them, and the effects of memory and inherited tendencies rule them, so that they tend to move about on the chessboard of life like mere pawns. By rising above these influencing causes, the advanced student seeks a higher level of mental action and direction. Dominating their moods, emotions, impulses, and feelings, they create for themselves new characters, qualities, and powers through which they overcome their environment. They now become the players instead of mere pawns. Such people assist in the game of life, instead of being moved about this way and that by stronger influences, powers, and wills. They use the principle of cause and effect instead of being used by it. Of course, even the highest are subject to the principle as it manifests on the higher levels. But on the lower levels of activity they are masters instead of slaves. As Summum says, the wise serve on the higher, but rule on the lower. They obey the laws coming from above them, but on their own level and those below them they rule and give orders. Yet in so doing, they form a part of the principle instead of opposing it. The wise fall in with the law, and by understanding its movements operate it instead of being its blind slave. Just as the skilled swimmer turns this way and that way, goes and comes at will rather than being carried like a floating log, so are the wise, as compared to the novice. Yet both swimmer and log, wise and fool, are subject to law. Those who understand this are well on the road to mastery. True psychokinesis is a mental art. Summum. In the above axiom, Summum teaches that the great work of influencing one's environment is accomplished by mental power. The universe being wholly mental, it follows that it may be ruled only by mentality. In this fact is to be found an explanation of all the phenomena and manifestations of the various mental powers. In back of and underneath the teachings of the various disciplines remains ever constant the principle of the mental substance of the universe. If the universe be mental in its essence, then it follows that mental alteration must change the condition and phenomena of the universe. If the universe is mental, then mind must be the highest power affecting its events. If this be understood, then all the so-called miracles and wonder workings are seen plainly for what they are. There is no why. It merely is and is not. Summum. Why does Summum do what it does? Why is there life? Why is there being? These can be difficult questions to answer, and can be dealt with by saying that the questions are their own answers. Summum does for the cause of doing. Life is the reason for life. Being is for the cause of being. These can be difficult and perplexing considerations. Just know that you can be with these concepts, and through practicing the ideal meditation attain the realization that everything is and is not, simply, because it is and is not, it is the result of creation's copulation. Summum is infinite, living mind. The universe is mental. The sum individuals call it spirit. Summum. Your new physics, that of quantum mechanics, has proposed startling new theories, so far, as the scientific world is concerned, dealing with the behavior of the universe and the nature of reality. Quantum physicists are now faced with the conclusion that reality is a product of consciousness. Their study of subatomic particles, or more recently, quanta particles, suggests to them that these particles, as small as they appear, have a consciousness entirely their own. Such being the case at the quantum particle level, it must follow that all matter and energy in the physical universe has its own collective consciousness, since matter and energy are but groupings of these quanta particles. Therefore, the material universe itself has a consciousness all its own. Quantum physicists are faced with the question of the source of the consciousness of matter. As your physicists continue in their search for the source of the consciousness of matter, they will discover that all matter has spirit. This spirit they try to understand as a form of consciousness. The collective spirit of all the units and groupings of units is summum. It is this collective consciousness which makes up the infinite, living mind which is summum. Summum is not some sort of giant brain in the sky, but rather the life force energy produced by the event of the bonding between nothing and possibility. Just as your consciousness is much more encompassing than the organ that is called your brain, so is the infinite, living mind of summum that much greater than all the collective raw particles of the universe. Summum is infinite consciousness in all its varied aspects. The sum individuals call it spirit. Creation manifests when balance is perfected between the opposites. By applying higher law against lower laws, the creation becomes divine. Summum. Under and behind all outward appearances or expressions of existence, behind all events, behind all circumstances, is the substantial essence, the bonding between nothing and possibility. It is for this reason that the universe is dual in its nature, and it is for this reason that spiritual development requires you to become conscious of that duality. Whenever you examine anything, be aware of the duality of that which you observe. Be aware of the two opposites which make it up to be what it is. Remember, where you find one thing, you will always find its opposite. By recognizing the duality of the universe, you can begin to look for the opposites in all events or circumstances, remembering always that the opposites are merely differing aspects of the same thing or event. In identifying the opposites, you can strive for balance between the two. Your perfection of balance between the opposites is achieved by the practice of the ideal meditation, for this practice will bring you to the point of equilibrium between body, mind, and spirit. This practice will move you to a perspective that is unencumbered by judgments and the constraints of a fixed mind. As you perfect your balance between the opposites, be ever aware of the correspondence between the levels of life and being. Keep in mind that the same principles are in effect at all the various fields and levels. Utilize the principle of correspondence to reason from the known to the unknown and observe the laws, as they operate on each level. Apply the law of a higher level against that of a lower level, for the law of a higher level dominates the lower. In perfecting your practice of the ideal meditation and becoming intimate with the summum principles, you will develop the powers of spiritual psychokinesis. Thus, you are able to easily and more readily use law against laws, the higher against the lower, and create a life and direction of your choosing. In such a position, you are most certainly in harmony with nature and truly your creations become divine. Amen. Epilogue. Energy can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only change from one form to another. while the principles cannot truly be lost, since they make up the fabric of existence, writings about them can be. Over time, many books have indirectly referred to them, but as a whole, the principles became diluted and distorted. Three individuals reintroduced the principles in an unadulterated form following an initiation back in the late 1800s, early 1900s. They wrote things down, progression continued, and today, there are people who meet in a pyramid for in-depth discussion about these concepts. Still, many people read about the principles, but don't do anything about it. They read and discuss and talk and read, but nothing happens with them. As the three initiates stated, you need to apply the principles in your life, use them, experience them, become part of them in order to make them real and truly understand them. So Corky started teaching about the principles at Summum, after he was initiated into them by the advanced beings, the Summum individuals, beings who are complete and whole. This is how Corky first found out about the principles. Then Ron introduced the Kybalion. Now when Corky looks back in life, he says there is a familiarity with things about the Kybalion that he did not realize until a certain point in his life. Ron had a familiarity possibly with people who had brought about the original publication of the Kybalion. At this point I should state the Kybalion makes a very significant omission. It does not contain the one grand principle from which all the other principles come. Perhaps this was on purpose. Perhaps it was too much for the people of the time to understand and the three initiates elected not to divulge it. But today there are a few people who can grasp it, for it was introduced to Corky during his initiation, and Corky introduced it to me and others who have been through initiations given at Summum. Today, there are some individuals who are attracted to this principle. There are people who have considered the idea in some fashion, even though it was never formally introduced to them. The principle of creation is the binding or birthing principle for the other principles of the Kybalion and Summum. They would not be without the principle of creation. While the principle may appear very abstract at first, when one becomes involved in serious study about it, the principle begins to reveal itself. And so, when Corky was preparing to write a book about the Summum philosophy, he decided to use the Kybalion as an outline, since this is essentially what the Kybalion discussed. The Kybalion had fallen into the public domain and under laws of the land Corky could create a derivative work from it. By adding the grand principle of creation to it, by discussing additional details about the principles along with further concepts, and by rewriting content in a style and language more appropriate for today's modern era, the Kybalion has evolved into Summum, sealed, except to the open mind. As the Kybalion states, all things change. The principles of creation are once again presented in a pure, complete, and contemporary manner. To truly understand these principles, you need to use them in your life. You will be attracted to these principles, as your essence becomes more and more familiar with their workings. Some people are already attracted to them because of work they have done in this or previous lifetimes. Others are not, for their work has yet to begin. Those of you who feel no affinity to these principles may first need to search and develop yourselves in other ways. But in the end, you will reach a point where you begin to study them and become initiated into them. There are people who, after discovering Summum, traveled hundreds, even thousands of miles to visit in Salt Lake. Something touched them and they felt compelled to come. For some, it signaled the start of something new. For others, it was picking up where they last left off. Either way, it becomes a time when the mysteries and wonder of the universe beckon, and nature invites you to dance with creation. Summum Bonum and Wa. Copyright 2008 Summum. All rights reserved. Explore, wonder, discover. http://worldwideweb.summum.us. www.summun.us.